get our people to repentance. Our brothers gotta realize they're the mightiest thing that God put on this earth. And it's time for us to lead. Take a soul. Standing fast in the faith. People need me, so I can't fall. We trying to elevate Enoch or Elijah or the Messiah. Keeping commandments, not try baving fire. You filthy if you full of sin. The kingdom you won't enter in. Such a bloody scene. Why she make it clean? For the husband come to glean. These women are tired of leading. Rest, so I'll make it plain. Messiah coming only for the elect. You better walk circumspect on the highways and hedges. Purging that spiritual house of all heaven. They feet are tired, they arms are tired. Brothers, where you at? Charge of a prophet. Gotta say the lost soul. Charge of a prophet. Charge of a prophet. Charge of a prophet. Charge of a prophet. Gotta say the lost soul. This is my charge. It's not exactly. Who's the king?
Pray.
Who's the king?
Pray.
What time is it?
What time?
Read that scripture again. Read it slow. Take your time.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 19 and verse 17.
Bring it up.
Hey, I want you brothers right here to open your ears and listen to this Bible. I'm talking to the so-called black men standing right here. You trap boys on the corner. Don't walk away now and after scriptures is coming out. This Bible is speaking to you. It's speaking to you. You brothers that always on the corner block selling dope. Selling drugs to your people, murdering your people. This scripture's for you. Come on.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
When you selling it, when you selling heroin to your people, crack to your people, drugs to your people, weed to your people, God says you hate your brother.
That's right.
Murder. Jeez. You are murdering your brother. You are contributing to the death of your own people. But a lot of you blacks, you young men, mainly you young men walking around with your pants below your butt, you don't give a damn. You don't give a damn about your own people. You hate yourselves. That's when we try to offer you a flyer, you shake your head. But if I was offering you some dope or some damn trap music, you would take that. Read it again. Read it again. God is speaking to you. Who are you, the Israelites? You're not niggas. You're not spicks. You're not Negroes. God called you the greatest people on this planet Earth.
That's right.
Now it's high time that you wake up out of sleep. Come on. Read it again.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
So what are we doing now? We're rebuking you according to the word of God. Telling you to stop selling drugs to your people. Stop selling Lucy's to your people. Pull your pants up. Get a job. Go to school. There's more to life than GDs and BDs gangbanging.
Bring it up.
You can't even walk down the street. You gotta constantly look over your shoulder because somebody's getting ready to blow your brains out. Split your wig. Like what happened to those three brothers the other day. That's not life.
Jeez.
Look at this place, man. This place looks miserable. It's misery.
Bring it up.
It's like I'm in a damn time warp. Trapped in the 1980s or 90s over here.
Jeez.
Everybody's prospering, but you so-called blacks. Why? Because the curses of God is upon you. The curses of God. I'm going to prove it. I'm about to prove it right now according to the scriptures. Give me Isaiah chapter 51 and verse 20. Let me show you a prophecy that's written in the Bible about you so-called blacks. And the other nations, they know who you are. That's why this damn Arab, this Ishmaelite man, every time y'all come here to teach the word of God, what does he do? He blasts his music, his trap music.
That's
death
right.
Music.
Teach.
To stop the word of God from coming out.
Teach.
But little do you know the word of God don't come out void. We're going to teach this Bible whether you like it or not.
Teach.
Whether you repent or not. Come on.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 51 and verse 20. Thy sons have fainted.
God says thy sons have fainted. Who's the sons? You Israelites.
That's right.
The Israelites? You blacks, you Negroes. God says thy sons have fainted. He's not talking about a physical faint. He's talking about spiritually, mentally. You don't know who you are.
Right.
Line up 10 Negroes, ask them who they are. You're going to get 20 different answers.
That's right.
We know we're at the right place. Why? Because there's cops all over the place in the hood. Why? Because you Negroes up to no good. Selling drugs, selling death to your own people. Listening to music that promotes death, promotes whoredom. We are the only race of people that do that.
Bring it on.
Come on.
They lie at the head of all the streets.
You hear what God says? The Israelites are at the head of all the streets. Look to my right, Negroes on the corner. Look to my left, Negroes on the corner.
Bring it up. They lie
at the head of all the streets. Of all the streets. Of all the streets. It doesn't matter where we at. We could be in Chicago. We could be in Brooklyn, New York, Flatbush, Bensonhurst, Bed-Stuy, wherever our people are at. Dallas, Texas, Atlanta, Georgia. Nothing but Negroes inhabiting the corner of the streets. Selling dope to our people up to no good. Stick up kids. Gang bangers. Ken won't even make it past the age of 21. And then when we teach you this, you give us the middle finger. You stupid as hell. Some of you are dumb as hell. Some of you deserve death.
That's
Let's
right.
get that out the Bible. We're going to finish that. Give me Proverbs 8, verse 36.
Bring it on.
We teaching you salvation, which is love according to the Bible, but you want to stick your middle finger at us.
Teach.
But guess what? You are the same people who stoned the prophets.
That's right.
You are the same people that put Christ on the cross.
Right.
That's right.
Come on.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 8, and verse 36.
Bring it on.
The sinneth against me. But he that sinneth against me.
God says, but he that sinneth against me. What is sin? Sin is transgression of the law.
That's
breaking
right.
God's commandments, like That's you young right. black men, you young women. God says, he that sinneth against me. Come on.
Wrongeth his own soul.
God says, when you sin against him, you wrongeth your own soul.
Right.
Come on.
All day. They hate me.
And if you sin against God constantly without trying to repent, that means you hate God.
That's right.
So when you sell drugs to your brother, guess what? You hate God.
Right.
You hate yourself and you hate your brother.
Right.
When you're gang banging GDs versus BDs, guess what? You hate God. You hate your brother and you hate yourself.
Right. Teach.
So God says, them that hate me,
love death. All they that hate me love death.
All them that hate me love death.
That's right.
So when you see black on black crime and y'all getting your wig split right open in the middle of the day dropping dead, God says that's good for your simple behind because you love death. So if you don't want to die in vain, keep the commandments.
That's right.
But that's so hard for a so-called black man to do. We tell you black man, stop killing. Love your brothers. That's hard for you to do because why you got hatred in your heart? All you know is hate from this damn trap music, that death music. That's all you know. Violence. God says you're the greatest people to ever touch this planet Earth. Everybody want to be a nigga, but nobody want to be a nigga.
Right.
You are the greatest people to ever walk this planet Earth, but you sure ain't like acting like it.
That's right.
What do I see? Drug addiction, right. violence, murder, young black men walking with their pants below the your butt. Right. Nobody want to see your boxes.
Right.
Pull up your pants and be men.
That's
and
right.
rule this planet Earth the way it was intended for you to be.
That's right.
What do I see? I see your servants riding upon horses.
Right.
That's what I see. Because the other nations, they supposed to be in subjective to you.
Right.
But here you are in America, the land of your captivity, acting stupid as hell. Don't know if you coming or going. Go back to the book of Isaiah chapter 51 and verse 20. Let's read the prophecy of the so-called black man that loves to hang on the corner. Come on.
This is the book of Isaiah chapter 51. And verse 20.
And listen to this prophecy, because a lot of our men and women, they think the Bible's a fairy tale. But God has the Negro recorded in this book right here. And that book belongs to you. The Bible's your constitution. It's not a white man's book.
Right.
2019, and some of you act like y'all don't know how to read.
Right.
The Bible says Christ's hair was white like wool. His skin was like burnt brass. King Solomon said, I'm black and comely.
Right.
Job said, my skin is black upon me.
Right.
What am I reading? Black people in the Bible.
That's right.
Come on.
Thy sons have fainted. They lie at the head of all the streets as a wild bull in a net.
As a wild bull in a net. You know what's the net? A net is a trap. Young man, can I holler at you for a second? You don't want to hear the Bible, right? Nah, you want to throw up gang signs, right? That's black people for you. That's what we've become in 2019. And many of you grown, mature men, you grown women, you think it's okay.
Right.
You think it's okay. The world is evolving, but the Negro is stagnant and regressive as hell.
Bring it out.
Y'all think this is living. Y'all think this is life. Just, you gotta go to the store to get a bottle of milk. You gotta worry about somebody robbing you or shooting you. Y'all think this is life.
Bring it out.
When a young man has to worry whether he's gonna live past the age of 21, y'all think this is life. Come on.
They are full of the fury of the Lord.
Now the traps that we're reading about is black on black violence. This crazy music that you listen to.
Jeez.
Lesbianism.
Jeez.
Homosexuality.
Jeez.
The prison system. All of that is a trap for our people.
Right.
To keep you mentally enslaved.
Right.
Okay, all of that is a trap. The LGBT, GTQ, lesbian movement, all of that is wicked as hell.
That's
thus
right.
Saith the Lord. Homosexuality, wicked. Murdering your own brother, black on black violence, wicked.
Right.
God says, they that hate me love death. And surely by our actions, black man, we are acting like we love death. Because everything we do is contrary to the Bible. Read it again.
Thy sons have fainted. They lie at the head of all the streets as a wild bull in a net. They are full of the fury of the Lord.
God says you are full of the fury of the Lord. You know what the fury of the Lord is, Anthony? What is his wrath? Very good. Very good. You've been watching us on YouTube or any Israelites? You're good. That's the second answer you gave that was correct. The fury of the Lord is his wrath. Where can we read about the wrath of God? Deuteronomy, please. The 28th chapter, the 15th verse. Who is this Bible for? You blacks and Hispanics, because you're the Israelites.
That's right.
Okay, come on.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass.
What's the it that shall come to pass? All of these curses that we're about to read, the prophecies. Come on.
If thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
We're going to read some of the curses. And we know your enemies don't want this truth to come out. Like Ishmael over there across the street, playing that loud death music every time the brothers come out here to teach the word of God. Enjoy your kingdom now, because your kingdom is almost gone. Soon you're going to be in shackles and chains once Christ comes back. What are we teaching? Deliverance to our people. Ishmael don't want to hear that. Esau don't want to hear that. But they want to play that Fredo Santana, whatever the hell his name is, and Chief Keith. Death music. They don't want you to wake up and realize who you are. Simple as hell. Then you got the Negro buck dancing in front of him. Come on.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Now, Anthony, we're going to read some of these curses. Young man right there with the fitted cap, listen. Listen to what the Bible's about to say. We're about to read the curses that fell upon our people. This is going to prove to you that we are indeed the Israelites. Come on.
Cursed shall thou be in the city, and cursed. Verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
It says thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people. Whose sons and daughters was given unto another people? Ours. What time period? What time period, young man? Was our sons and daughters given unto another people? What? You said what? A lot of times. Very good. But mainly what? Slavery. Our sons was given unto another people. Come on.
and thine eyes shall look, and fail with longing for them all the day long, and there shall be no might in thine hand.
You know what God says? There will be no might in our hand. Even now, when our young brothers are popping up missing, found in these empty, vacant buildings with no organs. That's a form of being given unto another people.
Right.
Our sons left us as orphans. That is a form of being given unto another people. But the Bible says our sons and daughters will be given unto another people. There'll be no might in your hand. We had no military might, no economic might to what? Save our children from captivity. And all the atrocities that happened to us after captivity. Right. Come on.
Verse 37. And thou shall become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword.
You know what's an astonishment, young man? A couple of years ago, they named Chicago. They said Chicago's worse than Chirac. You know what young black men in Chicago did? Mainly the ones that inhabit the street corners, the gangbangers. They rejoiced at that. America said Chicago is worse than Iraq, meaning the civilian casualties. Black men rejoiced that their own brothers and sisters were being put to death. If that's not an astonishment, I don't know what the hell is. We are rejoicing in the demise of our people. How simple can you black men be? We gotta be the most craziest people on earth to rejoice in the destruction of our own people. Come on.
A proverb and a byword.
You know what's a proverb and a byword? You're from the tribe of Judah, according to God. When I see you, I'm supposed to call you a Jew, right? Or Judah. But when I see you, when other brothers see you, they might refer to you as a Negro, a nigger, a black, African-American, Afro-American. Those names can't be found in the Bible. God called you Judah, Israel. So here in America, they call us what? Outside our God-given name. Right. That is a curse upon our people. That's a curse. Okay? Come on.
Among all nations, whither the Lord shall lead thee.
So Chicago's not the only place where we was made slaves. We were slaves in New York and all throughout the Americas. The Caribbean islands, we was made slaves. They call the brothers over there in Haiti, which is the tribe of Levi, what do they call them? Haitians. They call our brothers over there in Jamaica, who's the tribe of Benjamin, they call them Jamaican or West Indian blacks.
Bring it out.
So they call us outside our God-given name.
Bring it out.
Our people don't know who we are. We are lost as a people.
Right.
Get me, hold that, give me Isaiah 1 and 3, and we're going to come right back to Deuteronomy 28, verse 37. Let me show you what God says about our young men. These men right here, all of them. Guess what? At one time, we were in their shoes. We were the gangbangers.
Right.
We were the whoremongers, the adulterers, the murderers, the thieves, the drug dealers. But you know what we did? We turned our lives around.
That's right.
We repented. We realized our self-worth.
Right.
We realized that we are worth more than our pants hanging below our butts.
Right.
We realize that we're worth more than GDs, BDs, Crips, Blood, Nietas, Latin Kings.
That's right.
Vice lords. What is a vice lord? Where in the Bible can I see and read about a vice lord?
That's right.
Nowhere. That's why God says you are more stupid than an ox and dumber than an ass.
Right.
We're about to read that in the Bible. Come on.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 1, verse 3.
Bring it on.
The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib.
The Bible says the ass knoweth his owner. Young man right here on the bike, who's your owner? Who's your owner? That's what you get from black men. You get three fingers pointed to the sky, and then you get the F word, and you can't even pronounce the F word the right way. That's what you get from black people in America. That's how destroyed we are. God says you have a greater purpose, man. God says, look at this, these are the kings and priests of the earth. Look, these are the future leaders of society. But look at this thing. Read it again. Come on, this is a curse on our people, brothers. We got to break this cycle. We have to break this vicious cycle. And guess what? It's going to start with you, young man. You're the only one listening. But right now, you know what you're doing? You're defiling your temple. Why speedily bring on your death? You're smoking a cancer stick. And then you're blowing it out. So everybody's who's inhaling it is gonna catch it worse than you. That shows you don't love yourself. Truly, you don't love yourself or your brothers. It's true. You're looking at me like I'm crazy, but it's true. Come on.
The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib.
You hear what the Bible says? The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib. But what?
But Israel.
But what?
But Israel.
The Negro.
Does not know. My people does not consider.
If you would, you're considering that you're an Israelite, because you're standing here listening. Hosea. But these young men that are walking past giving us the middle finger just because we're teaching the Bible, they're not considering that they're the Israelites. No, nor do they care. That's why God says what? Verse the beginning again.
The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib.
God is comparing the black man in America to two of the world's dumbest animals.
Bring it up.
But they're not that dumb.
Right.
Their intelligence supersedes the Negro. Because these two animals, they know who their master is. But we don't know that we are the servants of God and we are the Israelites.
That's right.
Because look at the way we're acting, man. Look at the way we're acting.
Right.
Every day, every hour in Chicago, there's a shooting. Surely we are not acting like the kings and priests that we're supposed to be.
Right.
Now they will see the treatment of God. We are not black men, we are the Israelites.
Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.